शुभ समारंभां शंकराचार्य मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्य पर्यंतां वंदे गुरु परंपरा। ओं सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ओं शांति शांति शांति। सुखं नित्यं स्वप्रकाशं व्यापकं नाम रूपयोः अधिष्ठानं बुद्ध्यबोध्यं बुद्धेर्दृग्यत्तु निर्मलम् अपारं सर्ववेदांत वेद्यं प्रत्यक्परं महः तदेवाहं नमत्तोऽन्यदिति मे निश्चिता मतिः। So we are seeing the details related to Aham Brahmasmi Dhanam. First question was that this Dhanam happens to whom? Answer was given, it happens to Chidabhasa. Second question was, which was a little objection, that if this Dhanam happens to Chidabhasa, how can it be right knowledge? For that answer was given, that when Chidabhasa says Aham, it has got both the meanings. It has got both the aspect, Kutastha, Chaitanyam, and this Chidabhasa. And Kutastha Chaitanyam has got Mukhya Abheda. Therefore, by Mukhya Samanadi Karanyam, this Vakyam is valid. And when Chidabhasa is the meaning of the word Aham, then this by Bada Samanadi Karanyam, this statement Aham Brahma is valid. So that was the second. Third is, in this Aham, word Aham, these both are contained, Chidabhasa and Kutastha. Which comes first? Are they coming sequentially or simultaneously? If sequentially, then who comes first? For that, answer is given, that they do not come sequentially. Since they don't come sequentially, we don't have to answer which comes first. Simultaneously they are there. Simultaneously, Sakshi and Chidabhasa are evident. And the difference is that Sakshi is Svayam Prakashataya Bhati, is evident as self-effulgent. Means it does not require the shining from anyone else. That is the meaning of Sakshi Svayam Prakashataya Bhati. Whereas Chidabhasa is Sakshinaha Vishayataya Bhati. And the meaning conveyed by Sakshinaha Vishayataya Bhati, literally Antakarana Sakshinaha Vishayataya Bhati. And the shining comes in Antakarana because of the reflection of consciousness. That shining, that reflection is called Chidabhasa. So Chidabhasa derives its light from this original consciousness, and therefore Chidabhasa is said to be Vishayataya Bhati. Really speaking, Antakarana Vishayataya Bhati, but when Antakarana shines as Vishaya, then only there is reflected consciousness. Like when moon, in the moon the sunlight is reflected, then only there is moonlight. Therefore, moonlight is said to be Vishayataya Bhati. Surya Prakashasya Vishayataya Bhati Chandra Prakashaha. So similarly, Chidabhasa, Antakarana Sahita Chidabhasa, shines as the Vishaya. Alright. Then, Chidabhasa Sahita Antakarana Vrutya, Sakshi is not objectified. Sakshi is not objectified by the Antakrana Vrutti or Chidabhasa. Antakrana Vrutti by itself is Jadam, therefore it cannot shine. Along with Chidabhasa also it cannot shine because it cannot objectify, because the very content of this चिदाभास सहित अंतकरण वृत्ति साक्षी. सो दे आर डिराइविंग लाइट फ्रॉम साक्षी. देयरफॉर द ओरिजिनल सोर्स ऑफ लाइट cannot be objectified, cannot be illumined by the reflected source of light, the source of reflected light or the medium of reflected light. So reflected light or the reflection media of reflection cannot objectify the original light. Na sakshi vishayi kriyate. All right, then how the knowledge takes place? That was explained that antakarana means the beam of antakarana goes out, assumes the shape of the object, and this vritti, which is born, which is the modification of antakarana, always is accompanied by chidabhasa. Means not an accompanied, it is born with chidabhasa. Without chidabhasa it cannot be born. And this antakarana vritti, sorry, antakarana parinama alone is called vritti. So vritti, what we say antakarana vritti, what is the meaning? Vritti, which is generally translated as thought, is a modification of antakarana. So vritti hi antakaranasya parinama. Why? Because antakaranasya parinamasya vritti iti sanya. In that context only I gave idli example. That vritti hi, idli is what? Is the modification of the dough. Why? Because the dough, this idli is the name for the modification of the particular dough. Therefore this, because I was wondering that what for idli we brought, idli we brought for this, for example. Not that simply Swamiji wanted to talk about idli. It was a context. Okay. And how the vritti is capable of having the reflection of consciousness? It was explained, since it is a modification of antakkaranam and antakkaran is a swachha dravya, therefore antakkarana can reflect the consciousness, and therefore the modification of antakkarana also can reflect consciousness. That was said. Therefore ataha api karanat vritti rabhasa vishishta eva udeti. So in this whole paragraph, how this vritti is born when these sense organs are contacted with the objects, and when the antakarana assumes the form of the object, then the parinama of antakarana is born, that is called vritti, and that vritti is born along with the chidabhasa. Up to this has been said. Now the next topic really is 202. After this, next topic should be this bahyartha prakashe vritti chidabhasayoh upayogah. Because in this, the last paragraph of the topic, the avarta number 200 is vritti and chidabhasa. They were talked about. Therefore, the next topic is vritti chidabhasayoh upayogah. The application, the usage of vritti and chidabhasa in bahyartha prakasha, in illumining the external objects. That is the topic which is going to be developed, and that alone is the topic connected with this, what we saw the paragraph. But in between, Acharya wants to clarify that Ajnanam is located in Chaitanya. So Chaitanya Ashrita Avaranam, Ajnana Rupa Avaranam alone is removed by vritti. That he wants to convey. So vritti is removing the avaranam, which is veiling chaitanyam. To convey that idea, first he establishes that the ajnana rupa, ajnanam and its karyam avaranam are located in chaitanyam. Therefore he brings in that topic. Chaitanyam eva ajnanasya ashrayah visheha cha. Consciousness alone is ashraya and vishaya, the locus and the object of adhyana. For this we need to understand one more point. How we arrive at this, that adhyana ashraya is the chaitanyam and vishaya? First of all, we understand the concept of ashraya and vishaya of adhyanam from the ashraya and vishaya of dhanam. the idea of the locus and the object of ignorance will be understood well when we understand the ashraya and vishaya of knowledge. When I have got this pencil dhanam, then pencil is what? Vishaya. Vishaya of dhanam. Ashraya is what? I, prabhata. So, ashraya of dhanam is prabhata, I, ahankara. And the vishaya of the dhanam is pencil. And just as the dhanam has got ashraya and vishaya, ajnana also has to have ashraya and vishaya. And what is the ashraya and vishaya of ajnanam? For example, if there is ghata ajnanam, then we say the vishaya of the ghata ajnanam is ghata. And ashraya of ajnanam is me. I am ignorant. I have ignorance. In fact, we say I have ignorance means I am the ashraya, the locus. So generally it is considered that ashraya and vishaya of ajnanam are different. Vishaya, the object of ignorance, is ghatapatadi, and ashraya of ajnanam is I, pramata. The knower, because knower alone will know, knower alone will have knowledge, and knowledge and ignorance have to be in the same locus, then only knowledge can remove ignorance. Therefore, the knowledge, like knowledge, ignorance also should be in pramata. That is how generally it is considered. But our Vedanta Siddhanta is there that ajnanam has got its ashraya in a chaitanya tattva. Only chaitana can be, only a chaitanya, a conscious, only conscious being can have ignorance. So mind cannot have ignorance, and the object also cannot be the locus of ignorance, because object is jada. Mind also is jada by itself. Therefore, they cannot be the locus of ignorance. Why? Because ajnanam is always there. We refer to somebody having ajnanam only with reference to chetana. Therefore, the chetana, conscious chetana means conscious being alone can be ignorant, the locus of ignorance. Then object at least, ghatapatadi, pencil, etc. Then here it is going to be said, here it is said, we saw yesterday, that object itself cannot be the vishaya, the object of ignorance. Because object itself is jada. And jada will not have, if you cover the inert object with anything, it doesn't serve any purpose. Ignorance will have the job of avaranam. And avaranam is valid only when something is to be veiled. If it is already veiled, then it doesn't require avaranam. So jada padartha being veiled on its own, therefore it cannot be covered by ignorance. Therefore chaitanyam alone is the vishaya and ashraya of ajnana. And here it is thought more fundamentally. Ghatapatadi ajnanam, okay. Ghatapatadi ajnanam, immediately it looks like it is, ghatapatadi ajnanam is having the vishaya in the form of ghatapatadi, and this ashraya is pramata. But what about the fundamental ignorance from which alone the entire world has come? This fundamental ignorance called Mula Vidya, what can be the ashraya? The mind has not yet come. So the mind which has not yet come cannot be the ashraya of Mula Vidya. दैट इज वन मोर रीजन दैट इज वॉट दिस संक्षेप शारीरिक कारा इज गोइंग टू हाईलाइट द माइंड विच इज गोइंग येट टू कम पश्चिम कैनॉट बी द आश्रय ऑफ द अज्ञानम विच वॉज ऑलरेडी देर बिफोर द क्रिएशन ऑफ द माइंड. One Swamiji gave a very nice example. He said, generally in Indian setup, now foreign setup different, but Indian setup, children will be born after marriage. In foreign country, children participate in parents' marriage. That's a different thing. But generally, children will be born after marriage. So, he said, father cannot sit on the lap of his son in his wedding. Father cannot sit on the lap of his son in his wedding. Father's wedding. Can he sit?
Child cannot sit on the
lap. No, I am telling father. Not child. Father cannot sit on the lap of his son in his marriage. Correct or not? Similarly, who is father here? Mula Vidya. Mula Vidya cannot sit on the lap of her son or his son, whatever you call it. What is son? Child, son. So, Mula Vidya cannot rest on the mind which is yet to come. Like a father or mother cannot sit on the lap of their children. It is not possible. That is said here. That ajnanam, mula vidya, cannot have ashraya in the form of mind. And ajnanam has to have the vishaya. There cannot be unqualified ajnanam. Nirvishaya ajnanam is not there. So ajnanam has to have vishaya. And ghatapatadi have not come. So what is there available? Only all pervasive consciousness called Brahman. And therefore, the vishaya of this mula vidya is Brahman alone. The ashraya of the Brahma, this agdanam, ashraya of agdanam is Brahma, because nothing else is possible. Nothing else can become the ashraya of agdanam, mula agdanam, and nothing else can become the object also, because they are not there. Therefore, the only possibility is Brahman, Anavachinna Chaitanyam, is the Vishaya of this Mula Vidya. So, Mula Vidya Ashraya is Adna, Mula Vidya Ashraya is Brahma, Mula Vidya Vishaya also is Brahma. And by the way, one thing I wanted to clarify. Ghatadi Vishayaha Tamoguna Karyatvat Swarupataha Jadaha. He is talking about Agdanam in general, which we are experiencing. For that he said, Ghatadi Vishayaha Jadaha is inert. Why? Tamoguna Karyatvat. Now, Tamoguna Karyatvat, we can understand in two ways. Yesterday, I emphasized on the Sthula Mahabhutas. In Tattva Bodha, it is said that Tamasamshat, Mayayaha Tamasamshat, this Sthula Mahabhutas are born. Or these Sukshma Mahabhutas, Tamasamshat, not Maya. Sukshma Mahabhutanam, Tamasamshat, Sthula Bhutas are born. And therefore, Tamoguna Karyatvat, I highlighted that aspect. That Sthula Mahabhutas, the gross elements, are the product of Tamas aspect of Sukshma Mahabhutas. And Sukshma Mahabhutas are the product of Maya. Therefore, Tamoguna Karya. But in Panchadashi, Tattva Bodha, this is not mentioned, but Panchadashi it is said, even Sukshma Mahabhutas are born of Tamak Pradhana Maya only. From Tamak Pradhana Maya, Sukshma Mahabhutas are born. And Tamasic aspect of Sukshma Mahabhutas, these Sthula Mahabhutas are born. And the Ghatadi are what? They are the product of these Sthula Mahabhutas. Therefore, Sthula Mahabhutas are Tamoguna Karya. Why? because they are the product of sthula mahabhutas, which are born of the tamas aspect of the sukshma mahabhutas, which are the product of tamah pradana maya. Means tamah is little bit highly concentrated. Is it clear? The ghatapatadi are born of sthula mahabhutas. Sthula mahabhutas are born of tamasic aspect of maya, tamasic aspect of sukshma mahabhutas. And sukshma mahabhutas themselves are born of the tamah pradana maya. So both ways it is. Tamah pradana atman is there. Alright, so yesterday I highlighted only sthula mahabhutas, but even sukshma mahabhutas are born of tamaguna. Tamah pradana maya, not tamaguna, we only say tamah pradana maya. And therefore, agdanam tat karyam avaranam cha jade ghatadi vishe astiti yau kechit tat idam apata ramaniyam vichara drishtyatu chaitanyeva agdana tat prayukta avarane staha natu ghatadi vishe. The agdanam is obtaining only in the chaitanyam and not in ghatadi vishe. Agdanam chaitanyam eva ashritya tadeva vishayi karoti iti vedanta siddhanta. So agdanam object, the object of agdanam and the locus of agdanam, both of them are chaitanya. Why? Because agdanam can be there only to a conscious being. And a purely conscious being is only chaitanya, therefore ashraya. And there is no purpose in covering something which is already jada. And therefore the vishaya also is chaitanya. That was said here, ashrayatva vishayatva bhagini. Nirvibhagachitireva kevala. Non-dual, divisionless consciousness alone is having the status of being ashraya and vishaya of agdhanam. Here we have to supply mula vidya. And purva siddham tamasaha hi paschimaha na ashrayo bhavati napi gocharaha. Paschima refers to mind, etc. Mind, etc., which is paschima, which is coming later, cannot become the ashraya of the ignorance which is purva siddha, which is established earlier. Because agnanam, agnana karyam alone, mana adi jagat. Therefore, mana is paschima, later one. And agnanam is purva siddha. So, this mind which is coming later on cannot be the ashraya of the agnanam which is already siddha. Is it clear? Alright. And napi gocharaha. That paschimaha, the later one. So napi gochara, how we have to see? Paschimaha agnanasya gocharaha apina bhavati. The later one, the mind, etc., cannot even be the object of this agnanam mula vidya. Especially talked about in mula vidya. And once we establish in mula vidya, we can extend it to all other agnanam. So why paschimaha, the mind, etc., or ghatadi cannot become the object of agdanam? Because they were not there. When ignorance was there, some object has to be there. And ghatadi were not there. Therefore, what is remaining is only chaitanyam. So chaitanyam, which is free from any division, is the ashraya and vishaya of the agdanam. Now one question is raised. Prak saptavastha nirupana prasange अज्ञानाश्रयः अंतःकरण विशिष्ट चिदाभासः इति उक्तम् सच अज्ञानस्य अभिमानी आश्रयः. दिस आई थिंक फ्रॉम हियर ओनली वी आर गोइंग टू सी नो अप टू दिस प्राक. नाउ बेस्ड ऑन दिस डिस्क्रिप्शन दैट अज्ञानम हैज गॉट आश्रय इन चैतन्यम एंड द विषय ऑफ अज्ञानम इज आल्सो चैतन्यम, दिस पर्टिकुलर डिस्क्रिप्शन गिवन हियर seems to have the contradiction with what has been told earlier. So that is reconciled here in this next paragraph which we are seeing now. Prak earlier, saptavastha nirupana prasange, in the occasion of the description of the seven states of chidabhasa, agnanashrayaha, the locus of agnanam is antakrana vishishta chidabhasaha. Chidabhasa endowed with antakrana iti uktam. In this manner it was told. So, isn't there a contradiction? Earlier it was said that chidabhasa is the ashraya. If you remember, avruti hi, that the avruti, sorry, adnanam, avruti hi, bhranti hi, then parokshagdanam, aparokshagdanam, then dukkha nivruti and ananda vapti. These seven are chidabhasa avastha. So in that, adnanam was presented to be, sorry, the chidabhasa was presented to be the ashraya of adnanam. And now we are telling that no, kutasth is Brahma Chaitanyam, or only Chaitanyam is the ashraya, not chidabhasa. So how will you reconcile that? So that reconciliation is done by saying there are two types of ashraya. One is abhimani rupa ashraya, and other is mukhya ashraya. Like, let us see a very practical example. This pencil, I have kept it on the table. So now, what is the ashraya of this pencil? Table. But I say, this is my pencil. Pencil belongs to me, so I am ashraya. So therefore, generally I keep my pencil only, to give the example. So, I am ashraya of this pencil. Which type of ashraya? Abhimani rupa ashraya. Pencil belongs to me. I should not say, but I, just for example, I am saying. Pencil belongs to me. So, I am the ashraya, the locus of this pencil. As Abhimani. As the Swami of this pencil. And physically, what is ashraya? Table is ashraya. Physically, table is ashraya, or the, in primary sense, in this, the main sense, it is table which is ashraya, mukhya ashraya. Whereas I am what type of ashraya? Abhimani rupa ashraya. And by that, the reconciliation will be done. Therefore, here says, sacha agdanasya abhimani ashraya. Sa means chidabhasa is ashraya. The support of Ajnanam. What type of ashraya? Abhimani ashraya. The ashraya in the form of the one who has identified as the identified one, as the possessor, as the one who is claiming, as a claimant, this Chidabhasa is ashraya. Okay. And what is the meaning of that? When you said that Chidabhasa is Abhimani Ashraya, he says, Aham Agnaha Iti Abhimanaha Antakrana Sahita Abhasasya Jayate Iti Avat. I am ignorant. That type of Abhimanam, identification, is born, is there. For whom? Antakrana Sahita Abhasa. Chidabhasa with Antakrana alone has got this Abhimana. Chaitanyam doesn't have Abhimana. Only Chidabhasa has this Abhimana. Tasmat Abhasaha Agdanashraya iti uchyate. Therefore, Abhasa is called Agdanashraya. Mukhyashraya tu Chaitanyam eva. The primary support is consciousness alone. Kutastha Chaitanyam or Brahma Chaitanyam alone. Na Abhasa Sahita Antakkaranam. And not the antakrana along with abhasa. Why? Abhasa sahita antakranasya agdana karyatva. Because antakrana along with chidabhasa is the product of ignorance. And so what? He said, yadyasya karyam na tat tat adatat tasya ashrayo bhavet. Whatever is the product of something, that product cannot be the support of that thing. If A is the product of B, then A cannot be the support of B. Tattasya ashraya na bhavet. Tasma, therefore, agnanasya kevala chaitanyam eva adhishthana rupa ashraya. So, the agnana ashraya is kevala chaitanyam. Pure consciousness alone is the ashraya in the form of adhishthana. So, adhishthana rupa ashraya of agdanam is chaitanyam. Abhimani rupa ashraya of agdanam is chidabhasa. Therefore, there is no contradiction. See, when we have this understanding, then you will not be confused. Because in some place it will be said, Chidabhasa is the Ashraya. Chidabhasa alone has got this state. And some place it is said, Chaitanyam alone is Adhishthana. May be confused. But if you have this clarity, that there are two types of Ashraya. Adhishthana Rupa Ashraya and other is Abhimani Rupa Ashraya. So Chaitanyam is Adhishthana Rupa Ashraya. Chidabhasa is Abhimani Rupa Ashraya. Therefore there is no problem. And this idea is given in Panchadashi. There is a shloka. Ajnanasya ashrayo brahma iti adhishthanataya jagu. In Trupti Deepa Prakrana alone. Ajnanasya ashraya brahma iti. In this panel, adhishthanataya. Brahmanaha adhishthanataya jagu. Since Brahman is adhishthanam, therefore Brahman is said to be ashraya of Chaitanya. Ashraya of Ajnanam, not Chaitanya. Ajnanam. And jivasthastvam ajnanam. Jivasthatvam ajnanabhimanitvat avadisham. That ajnanam is obtaining in jiva, means jiva is the ashraya of ajnanam. That statement is based on jiva identifying with ajnanam. My ajnanam, I am ignorant. So he is claiming ajnanam, therefore he becomes ashraya. Both are ashraya. So fighting is not there. Swami, tell me, jiva is ashraya? Or this is Chidabhasa is Ashraya or Shuddha Chaitanya is Ashraya. Alright. So when you have got more material, you can please both. Otherwise, you have to take one stand. Oh, one only is correct. Okay, Ashraya is this Adhishthana Rupa Ashraya is Brahma. And here footnote is given. Nice example is given. Yatha Dhanadi Koshasya Mukhya Ashraya Petika. Just as the treasure of wealth, like gem and cash and all these are there, some dollars all are there, that dhanadi kosha means the treasure of money, etc. Mukhya ashraya, the support in primary sense, who is holding them? Dollar, gems, gold, etc. Who is holding? Petika, the box. So that box is what? Mukhya ashraya. He box only carrying this wealth. So he is Mukhya Ashraya. It is Mukhya Ashraya. But the poor box doesn't have Abhimana. See, today I have got so many gems in me. He doesn't have Abhimana. This fellow who can't carry anything. Aham Dhani Ityadav Dhanasya Abhimani Rupa Ashraya Purusha. Whereas Purusha, the person, he is the support in the form of Abhimana, being Abhimani. Identified with Dhanam. Since he is identified with Dhanam, therefore he is Abhimani Rupa Ashraya. What type of Abhimanam? Aham Dhani. I am wealthy. I am rich. So he is carrying it mentally. He is carrying in terms of this Abhimana. And therefore he is Abhimani Rupa Ashraya. So one is the Mukhya Adhishthana Pradhikarana Rupashraya, other is Abhimani Rupashraya. So, Shastra is focusing more on what? You give up this Abhimani Rupashraya. More and more you see that this really belong, doesn't belong to me. Money is there in the bank, money is there in the Almira or wherever it is. Why should I carry in my head? So, Abhimani Rupa, Abhimanitva, Rupa Ashrayatvam is there. Shastra says that you focus. But sometimes it is required to give up physically also. Because otherwise, sometimes we may fool ourselves. Ah, Swamiji, I don't have attachment to anything. Sab kuch chod diya hai. Everything, Swamiji, I handed over to my son. Only key, this, you know, treasury key I kept. That's all. Because he is very immature. Swamiji will spend away all money. Otherwise, everything I gave up. Everything you have. Abhimani from my. Most of the parents, they think that the children are still not mature. In their eyes, you know, because they have seen these children walking and getting difficulty in walking, talking, etc. So still it is there in their mind. Therefore, generally children don't grow in the eyes of parents. And therefore, what happens? Most of the, many, not most, many parents, they have got this thinking that my child will know, he will throw away money, he will not use money properly. I know one person, he said, Swami, my this son, you know, he always doesn't know value of money and all this. So son was spending his own income, not taking from father's pension. He was to feel so much, Swami, he's a useless fellow. So much he used to tell. Anyway, so this Abhimani Rupa Ashrayatvam is there. Since Jiva has got, or Chidabhasa has the Abhimanam with ignorance, therefore Chidabhasa is called Ashraya. Abhimanitva Rupa Ashrayatvam. And Jiva is claiming all kinds of things. So Ajnanam also it claims. Because you cannot claim partially. So he claims Ajnanam also, my Ajnanam. It is my ignorance. I have to get rid of. Therefore, Chidabhasa is Abhimani Rupashraya and Chaitanyam is Adhishthana Rupashraya. Okay. Vishayaha cha tasya Chaitanyam eva. So far what has been established? The Ashraya of Mulagnanam and Ashraya of any Agnanam is Chaitanyam alone. Now, what is the Vishaya of this Agnanam? Tasya means Agnanasya. Of this ignorance, Vishayaha, the object, is also Chaitanyam eva. He is consciousness alone. So, we are not protective about Chaitanyam. Chaitanyam will become Ashraya also, Vishaya also. How much Chaitanyam will do? Chaitanyam doesn't do anything. So, therefore you can superimpose anything, no problem. So, Chaitanya has got Vishaya too much. Tasya Ajnanasya Vishayaha cha Chaitanyam eva. The object of ignorance also is consciousness alone. Achha, how is it so? He explained. Swarupa tiraskaraha eva ajnana vishayam vishayatvam iti uchyate. So he explains fundamentally. This is what is the meaning of being the object of ignorance. Ajnana vishayatvam kim? The status of being the object of ignorance means what? He says swarupa tiraskaraha. Tiraskru means conceal. To conceal. Tiraskara means concealment, veiling. Swarupa tiraskaraha, concealment of one's true nature. That alone is called being the object of Ajnana. Swarupasya tiraskaraha. Tiraskara means concealment, veiling, covering of swarupa. Swarupasya tiraskara, swarupa tiraskara. So the concealment of one's own swarupa is said to be being the object of Ajnana. Means what? For example, Ghata is, in a relative sense, Ghata is Ajnana Vishaya means what? Ghata swarupa is veiled. So, Ghata swarupa being veiled is called Ghata being the object of ignorance. Swarupa tiraskaraha eva ajnana vishayatvam iti uchyate is mentioned in this manner. So, concealment of one's own true nature is said to be the status of being the object of ignorance. Etat ajnana krityam avaranam jada vastuni na yujyate. Etat ajnana krityam avaranam. The avaranam, which is the job of the ajnanam, etad ajnana krityam avaranam, etad can go with avaranam also. This avaranam, which is the job of ajnanam, jada vastuni, with reference to inner thing, na yujyate, is not tenable, not appropriate. Why? Jada vastunaha स्वरूपतः एव आवृतत्वात् तत्र अज्ञानकृत्य आवरणस्य प्रयोजना भावात्. He says, inner thing is already avruta, is already veiled essentially, स्वरूपतः, because it is tamoguna karya. it is essential already avruta because jada padartha ghatadi being born of tamoguna swarupata eva avruta it is essentially fundamentally it is already covered and therefore tatra agdana kritya avaranasya prayojana bhavat therefore there is no purpose of any veiling which is the job of agdana and therefore what jada vastuni agdana krityam avaranam na yujyate the veiling which is the job of ignorance is not tenable with reference to jada vastu means inert thing cannot become the object of the function of ignorance and therefore inert object cannot be the object of ignorance the logic is that the inert object cannot be subjected to the job of ignorance job of ignorance is what avaranam so jada padartha is not subject to avaranam which is the job of agnanam and since it is not subject to the avaranam which is the job of agnanam therefore jada padartha cannot be the object of agnanam because swakritya avarana dwara eva agnanam padartham vishayi karoti so the inert any agnanam is objectifying anything through only its job avaranam function that's what it was swarupa tiraskara eva agnana vishayatvam when something is subject to be veiled by something then only it can become the object of agnana alright tatha cha agnanam swashraya chaitanyam eva vishayi karoti so now nobody is remaining everything is jada and therefore nobody can become the object of agnana so what is not jada chaitanyam is not jada tatha cha and thus means what since everything is jada therefore cannot be the object of ignorance only chaitanyam is not jada and therefore it can become the object of ignorance it has got a yogyata therefore agnanam ignorance swashraya chaitanyam eva vishayi karoti agnanam objectifies vishayi karoti means objectifies but swashraya chaitanyam eva it support consciousness alone so agnanam will be in search of this object whom to cover nobody is ready to be covered therefore wo apna ashray ko bolta hai so I have to have some object so vishaya ashraya you are vishay bhi ban jao so you become the object also agnan did not get so ye agnanam is objectifying its ashraya only agnanam covers its ashraya all right and that is it possible that one and the same thing can be ashraya and vishaya of the same factor so yes yatha just as grihantastham tamaha means darkness which is obtaining in the house swashraya bhutam griham the house which is its locus eva alone avrunoti covers see let us see the example of darkness which is given here imagine one room is fully dark now where is darkness in the room means darkness is the ashraya of the room where is means what ashraya kutra vartate tamaha grihe vartate and what it is covering some object has to be there darkness so what it is covering what is the object grihameva so darkness which is obtaining in the house is objectifying the house so it is possible that ashraya and vishaya can be one and the same grihameva avrunoti tadvat tasmat ghatadau jade agnana varane na sambhavatah therefore in ghatadi jada padartha they are which are jade means inert tasmat therefore because of the above mentioned reason घटादि इंद्रिय पॉट एटसेट्रा विच आर इनर्ट अज्ञान वर्णे इधे प्रथम द्विवचन दि इग्नोरेंस एंड वेलिंग न संभवतः आर नॉट पॉसिबल सो सो फार व्हाट हैज बीन एस्टैब्लिश्ड दैट आश्रय एंड विषय ऑफ अज्ञानम इज चैतन्यम Now that particular information will be used while explaining what that what is the use of this vritti and chidabhasa in the phenomenon of knowledge. What is the role of chidabhasa? What is the role of vritti? And for explaining this, what is the status of agnanam? What is this vishaya? What is the ashraya? Those details were given because by Vritti, agnanam is going to be removed. And for removing the what is nivartya agnanam, about that clarity was given. Now the main topic means the connected, the topic which is connected with the paragraph, second paragraph of the 200th avarta is given in the next. Bahyartha prakashe vritti chidabhasayoho upayogaha. Upayoga means utility, function, application of vritti, the thought modification and chidabhasa. For what? Bahyartha prakashe. For illumination of the external object. In illumination of the external object, ghatapatadi, what is the use of What is the role played by vritti? What is the role played by chidabhasa? That is being explained. Acha. Atra idam bodhyam. In this regard, this following thing should be understood. Then only the topic will be understood completely. Therefore, this background information he gives first. He is going to talk about bahyartha prakashe vritti chidabhasayo upyoga. But for understanding that, some background details he gives. As I told you, very leisurely. So, if you ask him what is his name, he starts with his grandfather. That's how all related details he gives. Chaitanyad bhinnam sadasad vilakshanam agnanam chaitanyam ashritya vartate tenacha chaitanyam avrutam bhavati. He has talked about it. He is consolidating it. So that it becomes the basis for further presentation. Chaitanya bhinnam agnanam. Agnanam is different from chaitanyam in terms of vilakshana. Different not that is existing separately. But chaitanya bhinnam means it is having the different lakshana. How? Sadasadam sadasad vilakshanam. Agnanam is different from sad and asad. Mithya is for sadasadbhyam vilakshanam. So, chaitanya bhinnam of different nature, agnanam which is different in nature from chaitanyam, consciousness, that agnanam, chaitanyam ashritya vartate. It remains having resorted to chaitanyam. Means, it obtains in, it resides on consciousness. Tenacha chaitanyam avrutam bhavati. And by that agnanam, Consciousness is covered. By this, what is suggested? The Chaitanyam is the Vishaya of Agnana. The first one, Ashraya, was talked about. Now, Vishaya was talked about. Tena cha Agnanena Chaitanyam avrutam bhavati. Tadeva Katadi Swarupad Vibhinnam Agnanam Katadi Anashritam Api Swasadrisham Prakasha Shunyam Jadaswabhavam Katadi Rupam Karyam Janayati. This is altogether a new information he gives now. Tadeva agnanam, that agnanam, which is ghatadi swarupa vibhinnam, which is different from the nature of pot, that agnanam, ghatadi anashrita vapi, even though it is not resting on the pot, etc., swasadrisham, similar to oneself, prakasha shunyam, bereft of light, means bereft of consciousness, jadaswabhavam of inert nature, ghatadi rupam karyam janayati. Here janayati karta is what? Agnanam. Agnanam produces karyam. Karyam is product, effect. What is the effect? Ghatadi rupam. The effect in the form of pot, etc. So the main sentence is what? Agnanam ghatadi rupam karyam janayati. Ignorance produces the product in the form of pot, etc. How do we say that? Generally say, Swamiji, this pot is born of clay only. So if you say that from clay, this pot is born, we can understand. But agnanam this ghatadi janayati. People have this question, the agnanam is very abstract. From this solid ghata, how can it come? The world is solid. So somebody asked me this question. So I said, see, in the model of science, this whole matter is nothing but energy. So this matter is born of energy or not? Energy is abstract. From abstract energy, this tangible world is born. Possible. So don't say it cannot be. Sambhavana buddhi examples mil jati. You can get it. So now, how do you say that ghatadi is born of this ajnanam? If I say ghatadi is there in clay, in abhyakta avastha, and from clay, ghatadi is born. That you will say, aha, Swamiji, to sunaya bahut par sunaya. This pot, etc. is born of clay. No resistance. So pot was there in clay and pot is born of clay. So if we said mridaha ghatadi janyate or mrit ghatadim janayati, acceptable. Now we will ask this, that pot was there in clay, but clay itself is a product. So clay was there where? Clay was there in the prithvi. Prithvi was there in jalam. Jalam was there in the agni. Agni was there in vayu. Vayu was there in akasha. And akasha was there in what? Maya. So, hum ghada ko maya mein pohuncha dete. And that, so pot is there potentially in maya. And individual aspect of maya alone is called ajnanam. Therefore, we say here, ajnanam ghatadi rupam karyam janayati. Okay, this we need to understand, because otherwise, how do we say agnanam is creating this ghatadi rupam karyam? So immediately speaking, this pot is born of clay. But fundamentally speaking, this pot was there in avidya. So that avidya alone janayati means manifest this karyam. Karyam janayati. Tasmat. In fact, this idea, no, that from ajnanam everything is born, is a little bit more convincing for the people who are studying this cosmology. And they say, in cosmology they say that when this Big Bang start, what was there? There was singularity. And in singularity, what was there? He said it's the point of no information. One name of singularity is what? Point of no information. No information is what? Ajnanam. That's what we have been telling. Point of no information is point of ajnanam. They also are telling that singularity abhors the nakedness. Means singularity means the state is for singularity. That singularity as it doesn't like to be seen by anybody. This is very poetically it is said. Singularity abhors this nakedness. Like people generally don't like to be seen naked by anybody else. The singularity is feeling so shy. It doesn't allow anybody to see it. And therefore what? This is a point they say. This singularity is point of no information. So that's what we have been telling. There is a Nasadiya Suktam. That tamaha asit. Nothing was there. Tamaha asit. So they are somewhat coming near by that. Alright. So, but our Tatpuram is not there. What was there? In fact, in Mandukya, we are dismissing See, whatever information Shruti gives about creation, this is only Arthavada. This, the whole topic of creation is an imagination of Vedas. Vedas tells a story to tell how creation has come. You बड़ा आराम से सुन रहे हैं, नोट्स लिख रहे हैं. हाँ, वो आकाश, आकाश में से वायु आया. वायु में से सीधा नहीं, what from direct, no. In between अग्नि होता है. So you take very seriously. Then the Shastra enjoys bluffing. Shastra doesn't have tatpari in saying that this creation happened in this order. But the people, you know, feel happy that, yes, the details are there. When details are given, no, things become real. That's the problem. Anything, when you think too much about anything, no, then that thing becomes real for you. You try. You think about some possibility of some event. That if that event happens, really there will be a big trouble. Imagine this whole thing is flooded. And at that time fire also starts, some electric shock. How will we handle? This thought came. And now you keep on thinking, oh, then we can do this, but that will have this problem if you do this. And I tell you, you will be overwhelmed by that particular situation which is not there. So when you over-occupy your mind with anything, then it becomes real as it were. So creation, we have been hearing so much. Therefore what? It becomes a reality. Therefore in Mandukya, they keep on saying, not real, not real, not real. Both Mandukya, Gaudapada, Dadaji, Haran, bada jor lagate. So he really forcefully tells. But what happened in Mandukya, force is given so much. Afterwards, again, this other text comes, Brahma Sutra, Janma, Jasyata. So, we will say that. Anyway, so from Ajnanam, this world, the all the objects are born. Tasmat, Ghatadi Vastu, Andavat Sada, Avrutam Eva Bhavati. Tasmat means what? Ghatadi He Ajnana Karyatvat. Since Ghatadi is the product of Ajnanam, therefore, Ghatadi Vastu, the objects such as pot, etc., Andavat, like a blind person, sada, always, avrutameva bhavati, is always covered because it is a product of Ajnana. Therefore, always avrutameva bhavati. Ayamcha ghatadinam avruta swabhavaha Ajnana hetuka. He makes it clear. And this nature of ghatadi, what nature? Avrutatva, being covered, is Ajnana hetuka. Is caused by Ajnana. So the nature of pot etc. being covered all the time is caused by Ajnana. Means because of Ajnanam is having this nature of being covered. Tathahi tamoguna pradhanat Ajnanat pancha bhutotpatti dvara katadaya jayante. He explains further. Tamoguna pradana tagdana. Maya. Agdana means maya. Maya which is tamoguna pradana, having the predominance of tamoguna. Pancha bhutotpatti dvara. Through the production of the five elements, ghatadayaha jayante. Pot etc. are born. Tamoguna cha avrana swabhavakaha. And tamoguna is having the nature of failing. Tasmat. Therefore, घटादयः प्रकाश शून्याः अंधीभूताः एव वर्तन्ते. Therefore, pot etc. which are bereft of light, अंधीभूताः, being blind, एव वर्तन्ते. They remain as blind means all the time covered. Just as the blind person is always having the veil of blindness, nothing is seen. Similarly, all घटादयः are अंधीभूताः. More we'll see in the next class. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnam Gachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti.